Alrighty. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a Slackers Undercover video. I am your robot building host for today, Madog, and I'm bringing you Robocraft, a build episode. Don't forget, guys, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, ring that bell, makes such a lovely sound. Take a bite of that like button, not literally, of course. And please, please, share the content. Help us expand the Slackers universe. How's it going, guys? Madog here with another Joy of Robo Building episode. Today, guys, we're going to be making a dog sled. That's right. We're going to make a little puppy in the front, nice little sled in the back, hopefully get some good use out of him. So, without further ado, let's get started, huh? Don't forget, guys, mirror mode is your best friend. And let's start off with the rundown of the parts. We're going to be using medium cubes today, various shapes and sizes. We'll also be using the rods, so they'll be very useful to us. As for movement, we will be using the not even tier 1 mech legs right here, and also the skis, and lots of thrusters. There'll be lots of thrusters on this thing, guys. Might even do a propeller. We'll see. And of course, we will also be... I'm thinking a lot about this, guys. I think we're gonna have some Teslas on the front. Probably do the T3s here. And then I think what would be best would probably be the laser here. Might do these lasers. We'll see what fits on there once we build it. But and then we're gonna be using various different little shield bits of different sizes here and there. And we might use the Widowmaker on this model. We'll see. And of course we'll use some cosmetic parts and stuff like that. Alrighty, guys. Well, let's go ahead and we're gonna start off with our movement, because we need to see how big this puppy's gonna be. Alrighty, that's a big dog, guys. Not much room for the sled after that, so... You know what we're gonna do? It's gonna be a two-legged dog. I mean, it still doesn't fix the, length problem, but we won't have to build them as big either. You know what? It says this dog needs to be... have, 3 legs, right? Yeah. I'll just say the dog's missing a leg. Alrighty, guys. Let's go ahead and get those skis in here as well. Looks like yep, that'll be everything I can fit in there. Okay. You know what? Just for good measure, we'll keep those steer skis. And we'll make sure that... Are these really bigger? They are. Interesting. Alright, so... Could do that. And we'll go ahead and put... steer skis... outside there. On the inside here, and we'll just alternate these. There we go. It looks nice. I like it. Alright. Let's go ahead and get these cubes on here. Actually, can I put those steer skis one more back? Let's see. I guess if we had kept it straight skis along the center, we could have done steer skis on the outside. Not. Yeah, we'll keep it like this. It's better, so that way there's some steer skis on the inside and some on the outside. At first I was thinking about just making the sled guys, but then I was like, what's a dog sled without dogs? So I was like, we have to connect it. Really hate it when it does that. I think it enjoys scaring me. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and bring that doggy's head up right there. Do we? I don't think there's a cosmetic part that's a dog, is there? We got cat eyes. Yeah, there is. Where is it? There's a wolf head, if I remember correctly. How do these go? Okay. Okay, so we need to do a second layer of blocks next to this. Alright, let's go ahead and get that cosmetic part again. Gotta go higher with that because There's a lower part, right? There we go. Look at that Wolfie. He's so happy. Oh, I know. Can this fit in there? Sure can. There we go. There's his nice little woofy toe. Let's see. Thought I could fit those in there. There we go. And one more set of slopes. Alright, let's go ahead and complete him. We haven't even gotten to work on the sled yet, guys. We need to make sure that we don't overuse our cubes here, guys. Ooh, can we fit a triangle piece there? Can. Nice. Alright, puppy. Let's get some movement on you. Can you fit these nice big ones here? Yes, you can. Alright, let's go ahead and get these rods now. I'm gonna use these long rods right here. And then... let me just do that. And then one more time. we ought to arc down. Small arc. Baby arc. There we go. One more set of movement on there. Or we could put some happy little shields on our puppy dog. Let's see. What would fit him nicely? There we go. Alright guys, at least the sled part is very... very easy to make. Let's go ahead and just get these cubes in place. Or maybe, you know what? Let's eliminate that. And... now we can eliminate that. And we can go one more like that. All right, we also need to remember that the front is curved, so we need to use these. I wonder if we can fit rods through there. That'd be great. If it would have let us. It does. That is awesome. And then the short ones. Those first, then the short ones. I picked the long ones, short ones. There we go. Alrighty guys, let's get this sled built. I could fit anything in there. Let's see. Let's go ahead and put cubes there. Let's just make sure that we connect all this first. There we go. I like it. There we go, five across, I like it. Actually, I have a really good idea all of a sudden. There we go. And now, let us put some more. Actually, let's go ahead and just then we'll do that. That'll work. Alrighty, guys. Let's see here. I like it. These are like the reins that the dog sledders have, so kind of like that worked out like that. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and use two rods as the handles. I guess it was too early to bring that up then. We can do a short rod. So, and then okay. Just wish these were spread out one more piece, and then we could have really made that look like it was the leash. There we go. Now that's believable as the, there's the handles, and then that's the, the ropes, the leads, whatever they're called. I always forget. There we go. Connected in several places. Alrighty, guys, I believe that these lasers would be best now. So big. These are so hard to put on places where they'll work. The dog might be in the way, actually. We'll have to expand out the sled a little bit. Now we can do this. So look even better now. Alright. That worked out nicely. So now we can do this. And we can do the short rods. The curves. And does that fit in there? It's too big. It's okay. But now we can put this little cube there. And that works out just nice. There we go. That's a lot better. There, like so. No? Maybe this one. Bam. There's always a way to fit a part in there. Always a way. There we go. Now. Finish this up now. This is working out nicely. I like it. Let me look at my reference picture one more time. Nicely. Oh yeah, I like it. Alrighty guys, let's go ahead and get those guns on here, huh? You know what? Let's go ahead and Oh no, I didn't have to do that after all. Let's go ahead and put that cube back. Only cubes on either side for my DS, so let's go ahead and one more time. Boom. And boom. There we go. So we could do this instead, so it looks nice. Now we should be able to fit two more of these lasers here. There we go. And there we go. Okay, so our little doggy gets blown up. Still doesn't look like it's going to be enough room. We may have to rethink our little doggy, but we went as far forward as we can go with him. And you know what? We'll go ahead and go one more out on the sides here. We kind of need to. Yeah. Sorry, guys. One more time. There we go. There we go. Like it? And we need a bottom row. All right, now let's just get some nice little slanted pieces like so. Maybe I should do the big arcs on that one. Yeah, that looks better. Alrighty guys, let's go ahead. Oh yeah, one more thing. I wanted to go ahead and do this since I was doing that. Thank you. I know what to do here. We gotta place a cube there, then we can... Place one there. And then, we can fit a triangle here. Fits in there like so. All right. That looks a lot more believable. So does that. I like it. Okay. Now let's go ahead and put those lasers back on. Wait, what? I'm not trying to overlap parts anywhere in mirror mode. I wonder why it said that. That was weird. There we go. That should be plenty of lasers. Alrighty, let's go ahead and get our movement. I forgot to make that cubes all the way down. There we go. Here's for a reverse. And of course that won't fit. Two there. Let's see if we can't fit this piece there. There we go, I knew we could. There we go. Just to protect it. And for good measure, go ahead and just add that on the back. All right. I think we have all our bases covered. Let's test this thing. See if it actually works. Those lasers have to go out a little more, don't they? It's a shame. Do we have enough CPU left to do that? Yeah, we should. I don't see why we wouldn't have enough left. Might be enough now. Let's see. And we can do that there. And that there. A little bit of an oddball sled, I'll give you that, but how much do these cost? 26 CPU, huh? Yep, not quite enough. There we go. Let's do that. There it is. And now we should be able to shoot past our little doggy. Alrighty guys, let's test it one more time. That was an interesting thing I was not expecting. Actually does help him get up places. Nice. I like how it moves. This is great. Alrighty guys, let's go ahead and paint that. I am very happy with that robot. I just wish I would have had a little more room to pull a CPU on the LCPU. Little more CPU to put on maybe a module or something. So nice. Kept it at T4. That's good. I was gonna put the thrusters below, but ended up putting them back here. So. Ooh, I know what we can do. Cosmetic parts. There we are. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Oh, I like it. I like it so much, guys. Just because I'm paranoid about, I don't think I have enough CPU to do that, unfortunately. Unless I strip some from somewhere. Guess technically we don't need this platform. Good. We don't need it. I'd rather get one more rod going this way. Let's see. It's gonna be a long rod. All right, and then a diagonal. And one more diagonal. And a short rod. Yeah, let's turn off mirror mode for this. Because, this will have to be a shorter one. Okay. So we did need this after all. And then diagonal. See, if we do a short rod, it won't fit. So we're gonna have to do cubes there. Connection points now. Alright, let's go ahead and paint him. Sled will be orange, I think. Right? Or should we do it a brown? Lighter brown? There we go. Make it look like mahogany. Oh, we need to do mirror mode, sorry. Guys. That looks good to me. Keep those brown right there. Yeah, it's so hard to get in here. Black. Get my two big movements in there again. Yeah, so that protects it pretty good amount. There we go. That looks like he's got a leash around his neck. Yep. Actually, that should be the gray. Alrighty, guys. There is our dog sled. Test it one more time. Real quick and see how it does. That is wonderful. I love it. I love it. That just brings joy into my heart, guys. I have to wait to see how it does against other bots, but looks wise, I absolutely love 100% how that came out. This is team death. Is great. Kill the enemy team to win. The first team to reach the target for the wins. Is that running me over? There we go. Chop my back. My kill? Yeah, it is. this happen to the screen? Oh. Design does not move like I was hoping it would. Destroyed that guy again. Yeah, once my little doggy gets knocked off, I'm pretty easy pickings, but... Don't know how that happened, but okay. Mobility is just ridiculous in this thing. Uh-oh. Where are all the enemy robots? Here they are. else? Someone else killed something. I gotta figure out a way to give the doggy a little more health. But other than that, I absolutely love this design. I think the only way I could give him more health would be to cut part of the front off. And we could make him a lot longer than like I wanted to in the first place. And beef him up. But I'm not sure if it would handle the same way. Let's test it out in an actual player match first, and we'll go from there and see how it does.
But,
Alrighty, guys. Really surprised that the sled doesn't do better, but I guess the sleds are not really their own thing anymore, so you have to pair them up with something. I suppose I could put two wheels under there. Let's do that real quick. Let's see if we can do that real quick. Just two steering wheels. Let's make them black. Let's get the right color for this too. Yeah. Now okay, we need to go down one more block. One more set of blocks. Maybe if I put a ski that doesn't move in the back. No. Still not cool with it. Unless I do this. Let's see if you're cool with that. It is cool with that. That is awesome. Also means somewhere else needs to be like that. There's gonna be hardly any actual skis on this thing, huh? Now, will it let me get away with putting... to get rid of the unnecessary cubes. So let's go ahead and get rid of you two. And... yeah, you don't need all those. Nope, you don't need all those. Wait, how much are these regular ones? They're 25. Ah, so I need to get rid of two more CPUs somewhere. There we go. That'll work. Let's test that out now. Let's make sure we didn't just screw this thing up. Yeah, we screwed it up. I guess we should have made a copy and then tested it out that way. Nope, we're gonna fix it. Darn! I really thought that would... maybe that'll help when... it breaks apart, but... yeah, it doesn't help for anything else. Alright. Let's switch back to these. That's not the color I had selected. Maybe we ought to just do all steer skis. That might just be better. Yeah, we'll try one more experiment here. Keep pushing the wrong button here. Sorry, guys. Maybe we don't need the big ones after all. Let's just do all steer skis and see what it does. I guess the only other thing I could think of would be to put heavy cubes on the doggy, but if we did that, then he wouldn't.
There you go.
he wouldn't be able to jump like that, so kind of a bit of a dilemma we have here. I guess the only other thing I can think of to do would be we miss coloring a part. There we go. I could take trim off some stuff off the side here and put some shields there, but I think I'm gonna call it there, folks. I'll do any modifications in between episodes here and see what happens. But thank you all for joining me, and yeah, this is Mad Dog signing off, and we'll see you next time, Slacker Underground.